that we form the children. So, since in case of lens, lens is a transparent medium, no side is silvered or polished. So, both the surfaces or both the sides of the lenses are available for the process of refraction. Hence, it has principal foci and the multiple principal focus points here and there. All this on the left hand side, what we mark are F1, 2, F1, 3, F1, like that it goes. Whereas on right hand side, F2, 2, F2, 3, F2, like that we mark children. One more thing I want to tell you, one interesting activity they have given in your textbook to understand this concept of converging with respect to convex lens. Take a sheet of paper, take a convex lens and go, on a hot sunny day, what you do is focus the sunlight on the convex lens so that the convex lens, it hold it upon the sheet of paper. When you do so, the sun rays which fall on the convex lens will converge, isn't it? Why? Because convex lens is a converging lens. So those rays of light will converge and finally you can see a spot on the paper which you have kept in your hand. Lens of paper is there, sunlight bartha is there. So sunlight when it passes through the convex lens which you are holding in your hand, children, the light will pass from air to glass and again it comes out of glass to air and finally fall on the paper which you are holding and you can spot the image of the sun there. So if you hold it for long time and if it is too hot, children, the convergent power is so high that even the paper may catch fire. And where you can see the small spot of light, that is nothing but the image of the sun. If you were at school, we would have performed all that, children. We are missing you. We are at school. So I will show you the lens, by the way. So that is called the converging point where you can see the image of the sun. And if you hold it for longer time, the converging power of lens is so high that even the paper may catch fire. The intensity of light is, heat is so more from the sun, children. That is the reason the paper may even catch fire. So be careful is a caution they give. That is about the converging lens. Now, light chapter start maanak munche, introduction video nalli, I said you about optics. What is optics? I said it is a branch of physics. Wide and main branch of physics which deals with the study of light anta. So that term optics anta idralli optic anna word they have chosen, children. Iga nimge spectacles allo sigo angadi nalli what is opticals anta. Opticals anta la shop ge name ittaru. Why? Because it is with respect to light ashte. So optic center anta heltare. There we have studied with respect to mirror, a ray of light passing through the principal focus will, the ray which is passing parallel to the principal axis after reflection will pass through the principal focus. The ray of light which is passing through the principal focus after reflection will go parallel to the principal axis. Third point, the ray of light which is passing through the center of curvature of the mirror will retrace the path anta we studied, children. So here also the ray of light which is passing through the optic center, it is not like only above and below the principal axis the rays of light are passing. You know, torch bit takshna hinge hogu light anta na direct madakagutta, no, it will come in all the direction, children. This is optic center. If you consider the ray of light which is passing through the optic center, ee direction alli hogutada incident light andre, it will pass without any, or it will travel and beku pass and baju, it will travel without any deviation. Hengo hogala ade line alli hogutte ade line alli barutte light. So whenever the ray of light which is passing through the optic center of the lens will travel without any deviation anta one point you should keep in mind, children. So with this background or with all this information, we shall study about the actual process of the refraction through these spherical lenses. Mainly we will be studying about the image formation or the ray diagram with respect to the converging lens, that is convex lens. We have learned one table already for the mirrors, no, children. It is very much similar to that. The table na neeza nanpit kodad heldala infinity in between infinite at sorry, center of curvature, radius at F, between F and C, at C, between pole and the center of curvature. It is very much similar to that. This also has principal focus on the kalthumela. Radius of curvature is there, center of curvature is there, distance, all the distances here also will be measured from the optic center, early pole tara. So it is very much similar to mirror, children. So adrali pakka adre, this is very much easy to understand. With this background, one second, before that, let me just go through your textbook once, if I miss anything. Refraction by spherical lens, please go through this figure 10.12. Separately, they may ask you, show that the convex lens is a converging lens with the help of neat diagram. This figure is not. So usually we show reflection or refraction process by keeping the object towards the left hand side of the lens, children. So that is one important. I have marked few important sentences here. Adrali, first definition of lens, what you have in page number 86. Refraction by spherical lenses are second paragraph for the children. First sentence, a transparent material bound by two surfaces of which one or both the surfaces are spherical forms a lens. That is important. Next, continuity. This means that a lens is bound by at least one spherical surface. Such lenses are the other surfaces would be plane. Plano-concave, plano-convex. Illi avaru figure kottila, mention maadila. But I have said you in order to make you understand. Next, convex lenses are converging light rays. Concave, and it is thicker at edges. Okay, that I already said you. The center of these spheres are again here called the center of curvature, represented by letter C. This important thing I forgot to tell you, children. Two principal focus in the center of curvature, C1, C2, and the yard. Children, please go through the figure. The centers of the, see, a lens, either a convex or a concave lens, has two spherical surfaces, isn't it? It has two spherical surfaces. Each of these surfaces form the part of a sphere. So both the surfaces here form the part of the sphere. Andre, obviously, it has two centers of curvature. Mirror alli one side reflect agadu, innon side silver rod polished na thodutti alva. So one center of curvature, one principal focus, but lens and kudle two center of curvatures and two principal focus, children, please keep in mind, and they represent it as C1 and C2. An imaginary straight line passing through two centers of center of curvature is called the principal axis, and the central point of the lens is called optic center. I already said you. Next, a ray of light passing through optic center of a lens passes without suffering any deviation. And here the ray of deviation is straight line and party when the ray of light is passing through the optic center. Okay, jokes apart. The effective diameter, this is important. The effective diameter of the circular outline of a spherical lens is called its aperture. I already said you. This is very important, children. We should confine our discussion. Confine andre, let us restrict our decision. We should confine our discussion andre. Illi now we will limit our discussion. Ellige andre, in this chapter, to such lenses whose aperture is smaller than its radius of curvature. So, optic center in the principal focus gate. What is radius of curvature with respect to mirrors, children? Pole to principal focus is radius of curvature R. Hangene illi optic center to the principal focus is called the radius of curvature. PC, pole to center of curvature is radius of curvature R. Andre illi no optic center to center of curvature is radius of curvature R. Then what is OF? Optic center to principal focus is nothing but focal length F. All this I will tell you when we learn the image formation or ray diagram, children. So here, allunu navade helidvi, aperture ginta, aperture is smaller than the, lesser than the radius of curvature, and two center of curvature are equidistant from the optic center O. Such lenses are called thin lenses with small apertures. Here, we are confining our discussion or our study to thin lenses. What is thin lens or what are thin lenses? Thin lenses have aperture which is smaller than the radius of curvature of the lens, and both the center of curvature C1 and C2 will be equidistant from the optic centers. Andre, this is optic center. Andre, center of curvature C1, center of curvature C2. OC1 is equal to OC2. O to C1, O to C2 distances are equal, and their aperture MNO is smaller than the radius of curvature optic center. To C1 is nothing but radius of curvature R, children. So this distance MNO is less than the radius of curvature of the mirror. Such lenses are called thin lenses. And what all we are studying about the lens in this lesson are with respect to thin lenses. That is very important thing you should keep in mind. Next, everything else, that is next paragraphs, I have explained about the converging and diverging property that you can go through. Last paragraph only, if you pass parallel rays from opposite surface of the lens, you get another principal focus on the opposite side. Alva, object na ilido bandu, source of light or object na ee side alli ittre children, ee kade principal focus varatha, ee kade ittade ille bandu, ee kade ittade ille varatha. That is the reason it has two principal focus on the head. Nala adanna heltidare. Letter F is usually used to represent the principal focus. However, a lens has two principal foci. Na head FOCI, foci is plural. They are represented by F1 and F2. The distances of the principal focus from the optic center of the lens is called the focal length. F, I said you. The letter, small letter F, is used to represent the focal length. Okay. So that is all, children. Next, what you have is image formation by convex lenses. Please go through this and become thorough with this. Next video, it will be on the image formation by convex lens. And again, you will be studying this table, which is very, very easy. And these ray diagrams about convex lens are very, 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 very important. Let us learn it. And you can observe my F1, 2F1, in F2, 2F2, half head dala. Adala, you observe it neatly, and please read the textbook once again. Thank you.